Captain Wash, is it?
Finally, after 2 weeks.
Well, maybe viewers will think, and friends, that we film unboxing all the time, but in fact, I was just thinking today, when was the last time that we were unboxing here something?
14 days ago.
Yeah, at least 14 days ago. But maybe on YouTube, because it looks like we're unboxing all the time something. But hey, this is not the way to start the video. First of all, to subscribers and viewers, thanks for your support, for visiting our channel, for all your comments, for your subscriptions.
And for sharing, spreading the passion
for the RC planes, for this channel, to the rest of the world. Because we have tried many stuff and we always come back to flying RC planes. This, my friends, is the best hobby in the world. Eh?
Yes, yes.
And if you're still wondering if you should click on something, well, maybe today this will be something for you. Eh? And of course, this is the channel when we don't pretend nothing here. We just turn the camera on and what the hell, eh? What you see is what you get. And all this from an amateur point of view. Because we are filming from an amateur point of view, because we don't want for any of you to be scared of the RC planes. These are still not toys, they can bite your fingers.
Hey, why am I smelling gas, eh?
Oh, I don't know, because you were starting the engine just a minute ago, Captain.
Oh, yes I was, eh?
Now, Captain Blush, now hush, because, I have a story to tell you, eh?
No, be quick.
Now, of course, I will be quick, viewers, like I always say, I mean, again, but today...
You can just in case open the box, because you never know about the battery again,
of course, yeah, because, on this channel, we never know when Captain Blush will hit the on-off button. Oh, now I will just put this here and don't say nothing. Because, of course, if you see this foil on the box, this means that we have something from the Banggood day. Now, hey, from time to time, I still order from the Banggood. There is just a few stores in my life that we are ordering the planes. And today, again, we have the plane from there. And I will tell you this. Again, you will have the link below and you will have the code for the discount. Now, in which warehouse that will be available, you will check later, but today...
You know what's a good thing?
This
you can gather this foil and you can cover your greenhouse with this, eh?
What?
With this foil, eh?
Yeah, of course, eh? But today we have something so sexy inside here that this is amazing, okay? I won't say nothing, I will just take it out so you can see it. And of course, first viewers, come here. What are you coming here for?
I'm zooming in.
You can zoom in the camera. Usually you zoom on my nose or something. But today don't zoom nothing, because there is a story that I want to tell you right now. Why are we filming this? Now we all know, maybe you don't know, but if you're living here, and now Captain Bush, don't zoom nothing on me. Because viewers are getting scared. From this year on, we all know that the new rule came here in the European Union. If you want to fly an RC plane, you do have to take a test and you do have to get the license for that. Now, all that you can do through the internet, but I know that many pilots are scared. What does that mean? Of course, I have already got my license. Captain Blush is in the process, but maybe someone, but maybe someone doesn't want to take that exam, and I don't know what.
I'm waiting so I can bribe someone, eh?
Yeah. And for that, I have decided, because when I was taking those tests, and now Captain Blush, I will turn this around. I won't say nothing, you can just see this, and you can be surprised, viewers. But I will tell you later what does this mean. When you're taking the license to fly the RC planes and drones, and I don't know what they call them now, drones, because at first there were quads, and now they're all talking about the drones and the cameras and I don't know what, and because of that, we all have to take tests here in the Europe. But when you do the test, you can see that there is, how could you call this? There is a type of the planes and quads, for that you don't need the license or nothing.
Yes.
And those are the planes under 250 grams.
Yes.
They're considered a kind of their toys. But in fact, I was thinking to myself, okay.
They belong in the toys category.
Yeah. Let's make a few videos on this channel when we will show you the planes for which I believe you don't even need to take the license for, because they are under 250 grams. Now, it wouldn't be good if you were able only to buy some phony baloney planes crazy planes, imaginary planes. In fact, you can find yourself a plane, a warbird, that is under 250 grams, and you will still fly it as the big bird that we fly, that we have the license for.
Yes.
And for the first time here, we have now, I'm proud to present this. This will be a few videos in which we will research the planes under 250 grams without the camera. And for that, we can go right now, I can go aside and I can fly them here. I don't even have to be 150 meters away from the first houses and I don't know what, because they are considered as their toys. But we will see that in fact you can fly them and have ultimate fun even with these ones. Now, of course, we will start with the Yixin planes. Do you see this thing? The Yixin, we have had a few helicopters on this channel by now, and I can tell you that Yixin planes and quads and I don't know what helicopters, they're really simple, they do work great, they do look great, and they're, like I have said, they're simple to use, and they come with the 6-axis gyros.
And they're cheap. Exactly.
And they're cheap. For the cheap kind of money, you can get a lot, because you can't put the
what
price,
did you say?
You can't put the price on the fun.
What did you say? Cheap kind of money, what's that, eh?
A cheap money.
For the cheap price.
For the cheap money, you get a lot for yourself, and today we have started, of course, you have the variety of these planes.
Have you noticed there is actually a battleship in the background? Look.
Yeah, of course it is, eh? And today we will start with this one, then we will go to this one, because Corsair, because I think that the most iconic plane from the American Air Force, of course, during the Second World War, was the P-51 Mustang, which in fact was chosen to be the best flying plane during the Second World War.
Yes.
We will fly this one first.
Maybe we will even unbox it today.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Of course we can. But this time I can't be able, because I don't think that I don't have nothing to assemble from this plane.
But you can babble with the plane, eh?
Yeah, but I'm just telling you, we will start with this one. Later we will serve the Corsair, the Whistling Dead, because this one is the second one, so iconic. And of course, at the end, we will also try this Trojan, which is the trainer plane in the USA Air Force.
Yes.
And then we will go to the next planes, because there is so many. And believe me, my friends, the one will be really sexy. The jet plane in this small version. Now that will be something.
Does it exist?
It looks so realistic. Yeah, we will see that in the future. Eh? So, have you shown this? 6-axis gyro, yes. 1-key acrobatics, and the durable material. And let's see this baby for the first time. Because
finally,
I can tell you this.
Does it come with the transmitter? Oh, yes, ready to fly.
Yeah, of course. Because this is the point that in one box, you have it all. You don't need nothing else. Let's see what you get in the box. This is just something that you click, you buy, and you have the fun without the license. And that's the point here, eh? And we will see how much fun we will have with this and how does it look, because, hey, I really want to see. Now, are you ready to see the small beast for the first time, eh?
Yes.
On this channel, eh?
Oh. It's all assembled.
Hey, now look at this, eh?
Doesn't this look like an OMX?
Yeah, of course, eh? Because I will research also the OMX place, which we already were flying on this channel in the past, and I will check the weight of
even
the
though the plane is so small, you also get the user's manual, eh?
Yeah, of course you get, and I will salute for that. I mean, you still need the instruction manual. And can you imagine, even in such a small, just this manual is worth the money, eh?
It's worth $20.
I would buy this for $1, Captain Block. But of course, eh, let's see quick, because today we don't have much to show and to assemble. Let's see what you get inside the instruction manual. Do you see this, eh?
Uh-huh.
All the important things that you need to know how to fly this plane. Now look at this, eh? Mm-hmm. Look. So this is it. We will show this later because it's not important. This is something that
first,
I will...
turn the box around and first show the transmitter, eh?
Oh, because of course you won't throw this box away, because in this box you will carry your plane. But look at this...
First, tilt the box
over. Yeah, but look how sexy the plane looks, eh? Look at this!
Hey, wait, transmitter will fall out.
I will show you this.
Uh-huh.
Ah, of course, on the bottom, you have put the necessary things. And what do I see here, eh?
Spare propeller or what?
The spare prop already, of course. I will take out first the transmitter. Now let's see this. Simple transmitter, but still exactly like every transmitter that even for the, how would I call, the serious planes we have.
One key aerobatics.
This is the one key aerobatics. Expo. Show this.
Look, you got three rates, eh? Expert, mid, and beginner, eh?
I mean, what's with you? Eh? Surprised right now.
I've never seen this before, eh?
We had the Ishin planes before and the helicopters on this channel, Captain Blush. You know that you get it all. Of course, on the one key, you have the gyro.
Yeah.
This is amazing. The assist of the gyro, which I will use on the head launch. Then you have the middle rates. The middle, The middle, yeah, you have the expert, beginner, and the middle. The middle is just like some AS3X assist.
Uh-huh.
And then you have the expert, when you cut off the gyro in the plane, and you're flying the plane on your own, and then you can do the stunts. But you can do even the stunts in the gyro, in the beginner mode. If you push this button,
uh-huh,
you are flying, push the button, and then show the plane what you want to do. You push the button, do up elevator, and the plane into the loop.
I have seen this with quads.
Yeah, the quads have like this, eh? I mean, this is unbelievable. Of course, this is not some 2,000 euros worth of radio, but it is good enough for this plane and still good enough. And do you know what this is? Do you know what's the point?
What?
Because this, the new rules here that we have now with the planes, you can't even teach your kids to fly now on your own because the restriction is 16 years old, eh? You must be 16 or 14. I must check. 16 or 14.
Well, that's below.
And above, if you want to fly the planes. But this, I can teach again my son to fly with this, even though he is 7 years old.
Hey.
But still, you must be careful.
That is BS, eh?
Hey, Captain Blush.
For the restrictions,
yeah,
eh?
Yeah, but that are the rules. That are the rules, Captain Blush.
The rules are to be broken,
eh? Maybe try to do something else. If you will be listed in a club with the senior members, then maybe you will be able to teach your kids if they're younger than 16, but if not, this is the only option. But hey, let's see in the back. Ooh, look what's inside,
something was moving inside, eh?
The battery is inside, viewers. Don't forget to check in the back.
Let's see. Wait.
And this will be something, of course.
400 milliamp.
And I will tell you this, just one more thing about the radio, eh?
Yeah.
It doesn't feel bad in the hand, eh? It is a radio and it will do its job perfectly enough, eh? Okay. So let's check again.
Tilt it again. Now put it on the back, huh? Hey.
No, I will do like this. And I will take out now the second thing. Oh yeah, I will grab it all like this. I mean, it's amazing, but of course it's really good that with the plane you also get the spare prop. Now look at this, eh?
And spinner.
Yeah. Because, you know what, I will tell you one thing, that these are the safe propellers. Even if you will hit the ground, the prop will just fall off from the plane.
Uh-huh.
The prop falls off and you don't break it. But just in case that you don't, because it's so annoying if you have only one prop and you break it on the second flight, and then
Yes. Can
you imagine to order this and wait for a month to get the prop in your house? I mean, that is CK, and that is why they have put it one for your convenience.
Yes.
Now let's check what you have inside here. Of course, the landing gear, small and sexy, which I don't think that I will even put on for the first flight, but they do work, eh? And you can take off maybe from some, I don't know, from some really good pavement or the asphalt, because this will not take from grass. That you can be pretty sure. We don't even expect it to. Now look at this.
Uh-huh. Charger.
Let's see. Uh-huh, do you see?
Yes.
They are moving, eh? And of course you have the USB charger, do you see this? And
this?
The spare shaft, do you see this, to put on the plane? This is what comes apart, yeah, but this is unbelievable, Captain Blush. What with you?
It has fallen off.
Where it is?
Here.
Good thing, eh? Do you know why this is? Do you see this, eh?
Yes. Well, it doesn't look the same to me.
Yeah, but this grabs this, see? But come closer, what's with you? Look at this, viewers. This hooks together. This goes on the plane, and then you can see how the prop fell off if you hit it, eh? And now let's see this masterpiece for the first
time. And of course, the screwdriver.
Yeah, of course, eh? For some quick repairs and the maintenance on the runway, on the airfield, eh? When you go fly, of course, every...
I think that you need a screwdriver to put in the landing gear, because there are four bolts.
Yeah, of course. And you have it all, because like I said, my friends, with this you don't need to buy nothing else. All you have is here, and of course...
Except for one thing. Double A batteries, I think, eh?
Yeah, the batteries for the back, but then you can buy in any store.
Yes.
And you can choose how many batteries you get with the plane.
Oh, yeah?
Of course, eh? And now let's see this baby for the first time. Of course, I will save this, because once I will fly...
You have only one battery?
Yeah. I think that one must be inside. Yeah, of course, eh? Because you have the option for two batteries or for three batteries. Uh-huh. I have ordered one with the one spare, because two batteries will be enough. If you have three planes, that will be enough.
Show me underneath.
But, eh? Eh? Look at this, eh? Look at this and be impressed.
Hey.
Do you see this?
Hey,
do you see the solution?
Hey, it's not some phony baloney server. Look at this. It's a real one.
Of course it is not, viewers. This is not some, I don't know, like I have said, the imaginary phony baloney plane.
Landing gear goes here and you screw in the screws, the battery hatch. Hey, but it's made really
good. For this size, give it to me. Give it to me,
look,
and I will show it like
made.
This. And I will salute Asian for this. Because to have such a small plane and to look so scale, and not just that, this is the red tail plane. Do you see this, eh?
Yes.
Do you see this? The Tuskegee Airmen were flying this, the iconic red tail Mustang. I mean, hey. And you can see, do you see why this plane will fly good, eh? Show the shape of the wing. Do you see this?
Yes.
Do you see how it's made?
Uh-huh.
A little curve, so that means that this plane will be able to fly slowly, because the air will come underneath this. This is the first wing that you have. I mean, you have many types of the wings, but this one is to really to get the most of the air underneath, so he is already lying and cruising on the air. Eh? I mean, look at this, and you can see even the guns in the front, and look at this. All the panels, do you see this, eh? For such a small plane, look how scaled
it looks,
the exhaust! But this is unbelievable.
Even if you don't fly the planes, you can just buy it and you can have it in your office behind beside the computer, eh?
I always got to watch for this, eh? Because even if you won't fly this, you can have the collection of these planes. Look at this, look, when you put the wheels on.
Hey,
look,
do you know where you can put it, eh? Under your mirror in your car, hang it like a smell tree or whatever.
And you can really hang this one in your car, eh?
Yes.
To have the hands here and put it in your car, and when you have the time stop beside the road and just fly a little, eh? I mean, this is unbelievable, and it has. Look at this side, eh? Do you see this side? Because this plane has all, like the big planes, this is amazing. I mean, it doesn't have the retractable landing gear, it doesn't have the flaps, but you have the ailerons, you have even the working rudder. Now this is unbelievable. Papa, show this close.
Don't touch it, no.
This is sick. This is sick, eh? You have the rudder and you have the elevator, and look at the reinforcement on the wings and on the ailerons. I mean, but this is unbelievable, eh? This is unbelievable. Viewers, I'm blown away this time, eh?
There are real servos inside. Look at this, eh?
Yeah, but two servos in the back. Do you see for the back? Two small servos
in
the back.
I'm just now showing the one on left and one on right side. It has three real servos inside, eh?
Yahweh! To just hold it in your hand, I mean, this is so special. And can you imagine how sexy this will fly, eh?
Now put in the landing gear.
The gyro, of course, will help. I know that it will. Like this. So this one goes here.
Mm-hmm.
This one goes here. And of course, then you put the screw, and that's it, eh? And I will put one here, so we can put it at least a little on the table.
Yeah.
My
crooked fingers, eh? Well, good enough, eh?
Well, hey, I'm having a real problem here with this crazy hand of mine.
But who cares about the landing gear?
Yeah, but you can push them a little inside.
But you can put it in later, eh?
What's with you, eh? Slowly and sexy, eh?
Uh-huh.
Look at this, eh?
That's it.
Hey! No,
hey,
no,
I think
go, that, go close with
I
the
think
camera.
That would even start from the table, eh?
Yeah, of course, eh? You always stuck your camera in my nose, stuck the camera now in this, Lior, eh? I mean, look how sexy it looks. It looks like a real one, eh? This is unbelievable. Of course, you don't have the steering on the back wheel, but that would be crazy. To such a small plane that it would have that, it would be crazy. But you don't even need it, because you can steer with the rudder here, with this rudder, when you take off. But this won't take. This will not take 100 meters to take
this
off.
This will take 2 meters, eh?
And this will take off in 2 meters. Of course, we don't have such a sexy asphalt for this. And of course, I don't think that you will fly this in some crazy windy weather. I mean, that would be nothing. This is for the calm days. And I have said you can even fly this in your backyard. And as far as I know, you don't need any license to fly this. But still, you will have the perfect experience. It will be exactly the same like flying the 1.5 meter one. If you will fly slow and sexy and close to you, you will have the same pleasure. I mean, yours. That's the point here, eh? You must try to understand. It doesn't matter if you have 1.5 meter, if you have 500 millimeters, 15 meter wingspan plane. Once you are in the air, it's just you on the plane, and the size really doesn't matter. Of course, the bigger the plane, the more sexy will fly. But now that you have this technology with the 6-axis gyro, eh? Any kid can fly this plane, and he will have the experience how it was to fly the warbird during the Second World War, and you will see it.
Yes.
But you must remember that by doing that, and by clicking on such a sexy planes and in this hobby, you will become an addict for the lifetime. But like we always say, this is a good addiction. It will cost you some money, but today we have something so cheap that I don't think that you will be broke if you buy yourself this plane and have fun for the first time, eh?
Yes.
Because for this, I don't know, it would be good, I will put also this here, if you have tried to fly planes on the simulator before, but I don't think that you need the simulator for this, eh? If you get the few basic ideas of how the planes will fly, try it a little on the ground, what some stick will do, eh? You can't even crash this one because it's so small and the prop will just fell off and you will put it back on and you will have time of life. And can you imagine, I mean viewers, what is the most exciting thing? Do you know what's the most exciting thing here, Captain?
What?
That you don't need to have a 5,000 euros or dollars worth of plane to have fun and to feel good with your friends or just by yourself, eh? Even with this, you can have the time of your life, and that's the point of this channel, eh? And that is why we try to show you as many different planes as possible, because I think that at the end, when we show you so much videos of the planes, you will find yourself something that will catch your eye, and you will say to yourself, oh my God, I will click on that, and what the hell, eh? I must try this for the first time, and that's it, eh? And thanks to the Patricis brothers, Pilot Robert and Captain Blush, I have found this amazing hobby, and that's it, Captain.
Yes.
Now, Captain Blush, quick! Because what?
There is a lot to film.
Screw that, because at this point, when Captain Blush will turn on the camera, I will grab this plane in my hand again, and I will admire it at least for 5 minutes before we start to film another one. And I can't wait to test this one, eh? I mean, eh? I will grab it in my hands once more because when you see something on the picture on the internet, when you choose, you don't see the justice to the planes. Now, sometimes you are surprised. Sometimes the plane when you get are not so good as they look on the internet. But there are times.
I was surprised yesterday, yes.
Yeah. But you can be surprised sometimes because when you get the plane home, it's even 100,000 times
better than it looked on the internet. And when you hold it in your hand, I mean, Yahweh, this is yours. I feel like I'm 6 years old kid, and I see that this is my first plane in my life. This is really how I feel every single time we unbox the plane. And many viewers ask me, well, which plane is your favorite? And I will tell you right now, which plane is my favorite in my life? Do you know which one?
ME262?
No, always the next one.
Oh yeah.
The next plane that we unbox is my favorite one. Like,
well, the interesting thing is that the 400 millimeter plane and 25 minutes of filming, eh?
Again?
Yeah.
Well, hey, Captain,
what do you think it would be? 6 meter wingspan, eh?
Hey, it's amazing. I mean, viewers, sorry, but like I have said many times, if you are expecting the 5 minute videos, well, then this is not the channel for you. For that, you have the 5 minute crafts.
Yes.
When you learn how to do something in 5 minutes. But on this channel, we love to have fun with you because you all feel at home here, and that's it. I can see that Captain Blush is hurting his hand.
Yes.
He can't film anymore, so I will stop at this point. And of course, like I said, you have the link below. And believe me, at this point, I didn't even try it yet, but if I just buy this and hang it and have it in my office like this, it is worth its money. And if we will be able to fly it good, I mean, that will be, this will be, I don't know what we'll call this. This will be perfection, the foam dreams for me.
Yes.
Stacy, thanks again, viewers, and just expect more, because the small birds are coming also to this channel, not just the big giant, And we will see what kind of planes we can buy that we don't need the license to fly them. And this is so sexy and interesting. I can't wait to see the next one. Look at that wind. I don't think that we will fly this plane today or tomorrow because the wind is angry, my friends.
Yes.
Like an old man returning his soup to the deli.
Yeah, yeah.
Like George said in Seinfeld. George Costanza. Jason Alexander, if you're watching this channel,
yeah.
You were the best in Seinfeld. Good Captain Mark, what's with you?